We're here at the Paley Fest, and we're staying with one of the executive producers for the show, right? Can I ask you a question, Greg? So in this project, how much of it is actually based on current events and also accurate stories that are being depicted right now in the common day?
I think one of the things we want to do on All Rise is, like, we're always, the paper's always open, our screens are always open to the news sites. We're going to do stories that are torn from the headlines. One of the episodes is going to take on ICE in the courthouse. So we're going to really mix it up. Some of it's going to be torn from the headlines, and some of it is going to be torn from our imaginations, looking for ways to put our characters judicial dilemmas, personal dilemmas, ethical dilemmas, and have a lot of fun while we're doing it.
And for such a serious project, you know, why now? Why now is this the moment? In 2019, are we going to release this project? Is it going to, you know, how do you see it affecting the culture and moving the climate for it?
That's a great question. You know, one of the things when we started making this is, why do a legal show now? What's the 21st century version of it? And for us, it's about character. We've never seen a character like Lola Carmichael on the bench. We've never seen an African-American woman looking down on the clients of the justice system, and what would she say? What would she do? What would she do differently? And I feel like that's a perspective that we need to see on television, and we actually need in real life in the justice system.
So how was it creating this project? Was it one of your more difficult projects, or was it just something that was just super easy, just fly off the pages?
No project is easy, but I have to say that this project seemed to have a life of its own. I'm working with some tremendous partners, producing partners. Michael Robin, who came off the Closer, Major Crimes. He came up in the Steve Bochco organization. Len Goldstein, Sunil Nayar, who's executive producer and co-showrunner. This is a deep bench of amazing producers who have all contributed. And our partners at Warner Brothers and CBS, everybody was pulling in the same direction. Everybody really wanted this to happen and to make it on the air. And so it's been challenging in the way that, you know, trying to come up with something fresh and exciting that America will want to watch is always challenging. But we've got this remarkable team behind us, including our actors. And so that has made the tough parts a little bit easier.
Now, you said this is, you know, the climate of what America's watching right now. At home, what are you watching right now? What is your favorite TV show and why?
Oh, my God.
That's a tough one.
It's a really tough one. My wife was asking me last night if I've seen the final season of Game of Thrones yet, because I was such a huge fan. And I haven't. So I'm not really watching TV right now because I'm so busy making it. But the next thing up is the final season of Game of Thrones.
Absolutely. I haven't watched it all the way either yet. So we're both probably, you know, watching it at the same time.
Right, let's compare notes.
Exactly. Well, thank you so much for stopping to AfterBuzz TV. I can't wait to watch it. You're definitely breaking grounds with this new trailer, and I love it so far, and I can't wait to see the episode.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.